If you've ever made Yorkshire puddings, you know that getting them to rise is absolutely key. In our last attempt, we made a lot of mistakes, but this time I think we finally figured out the best way to make Yorkshire puddings. Step 1. Sift your flour. The batter needs to be as smooth as possible, so any lumps of dry flour are no good. Once the flour is sifted, add 4 large eggs, 175 grams of whole milk, 25 grams of water, and about 2 grams or half a teaspoon of salt. Some recipes say to mix the wet ingredients together before adding to the dry ingredients, but we found that doing it this way worked just fine. You need to make sure you really whisk the batter well. I'll say it again, you want 0 lumps to get the best rise. We even went one step further by straining the batter through a sieve after mixing to get rid of any remaining lumps. The batter now needs to rest. If you're in a hurry, 10 to 30 minutes is fine, but if you plan ahead and rest your batter in the fridge overnight, the results are pretty amazing. Just make sure it's sealed with plastic wrap or in an airtight container. When you're ready to bake, uncover the batter and transfer it to a pitcher. This is key. The faster you're able to fill the cups, the better your Yorkshire puddings will be. This was our fatal mistake last time. Set the pitcher aside while you prep your muffin tin by squirting or pouring about 1 teaspoon of vegetable oil or fat into the bottom of each cup. Make sure you use an oil with a high smoke point, otherwise it will burn. Now place the muffin tray into a preheated 450-degree oven for about 10 minutes. When it's ripping hot, move quickly to pour your batter about 3/4 of the way up each cup. The oil should bubble and sizzle when you do this. Return the tray to the oven for about 18 minutes or until they have quadrupled in size. Whatever you do, do not open the door until they're done. I really think we nailed this one. Look at how huge they got. As soon as you open the oven and take them out, the puddings will start to fall quite quickly, as you can see, so serve them immediately. They should be crispy on the outside and fluffy and tender on the inside. Let's just watch that rise one more time, and subscribe to Dish for more baking recipes.